Anybody know your Bible? They will know nothing happen unless God allow it. God allow a thief to thief in panel van. Because he walk in during the day and he got he carrying pizza or KFC or something. He's a delivery man in the night. Time to be in the church, he delivering KFC and pizza all about my people's house. God allow the van to be stolen. And when I take the van now, he come and he tell me, he say, yeah, you know the thief the van, so I think you know. Lord, I wonder if that's a good thing or a bad thing. And he say, I'm preferring to get back the van now. So I'm thinking now if you pray, boy, really pray for this man to get back the van, boy. Because if he get back the van, he gonna get back busy. If he have no van, he will make time for God. Only understand? Only understand what I'm saying? So, the van is an obstacle in his life. A vehicle is supposed to be a transport in your life, not an obstacle in your life, people. A transport. When you have a vehicle, it's supposed to be a transport. God provided a vehicle for you. You could come to church, you could praise God. Long time was donkey cart and Jesus rode on donkey and all kind of thing. Now you have air condition. Now you can dress your hair among your plop. That's why I always set up the glass in my car. You want nothing plop and I come in on the road. This girl is a hairdresser. First time she comes, this girl with the blue hair, Elira. She want to put a perm in my head. My head good soul, yeah. Right, what I'm saying, people, is that whatever is an obstacle in your life, you need to remove it. Because if you don't remove it, now don't go home and say, your wife is an obstacle and run your man from your house, and I didn't need that. But when you preach it, you have to make sure, tell people you're writing, you know. A guy went to church and he said, getting rid of the old, I'm bringing new. You run the old lady, you know? Yeah, old man. You want to bring in a young thing? You run the old lady. So, what I'm saying, whatever is an obstacle in your life, you need to observe it and realize that is an obstacle in your life. If you realize every time you come to church, you get a belly pain. Somebody called me this morning, you know, and they said they have a back pain and a belly pain. I tell them, I say, let me tell you on the phone. You see, from 10 to 12 o'clock, we have back pain and belly pain gone. You see, then go to church, from 10 o'clock, go back to 12. From the time church over, and back pain and belly pain gone. Sister Mary laughing, that happened to you already? All right. Nah, man, I feel someone there. I'm not talking the truth. I should have happened to someone there already. That never happened to nobody in the church. Who did have raise other hand? Let me see if it have any on it. Look, Sarah. Right, look, my brother there, Narissa. Narissa is not my brother. I'm talking about my brother. Yeah. Narissa is a sister. Who? Rina? Time to come to church. Where you got? Belly pain or back pain? Eric. And then after church finish, you get back with it. That's the devil. And that's the devil. So you need to recognize when the girl called me this morning, I prayed through the phone. She said, prophet, you know all the pain gone? But I'm watching the time now. Now when she never should have been. It's 9:30. We're living up there in Jerry Church at this time. I said, so why didn't call me yesterday evening? So I would have prayed for you for yesterday evening and you would have been able to come to church this morning. Hey people, there's a real nasty devil out there now. There is a real Satan out there. And he's a deceiver. He comes to kill, to steal, and to destroy. He's a deceiver. He's going to deceive you. Time for you to come and get prayer. Time for you to come in the presence of God. He's going to bring all sorts of pain upon your body, all sorts of pain, roughness in your body. Because he knows when you step in the presence of God, you will be set free. Let me tell you something. I can imagine loving a God and see the devil have victory over my life. Never. Never. You may try, but you'll never be able to succeed. I made a comment earlier. I said, see, this church, anybody push down this church, they can push down God. Put your best shot out. Bring your biggest devil in your life. Not this one, not this one, not this one, not this one. People. Because our God is an awesome God. He's a consuming fire. And who is the church? We are the church. This is the building. The minute you walk in the church and you start receiving the anointing power, and you start receiving the Spirit of God, let me tell you, I won't tell you the devil will not stop trying, you know. He will try. He will try till he realizes, hey, I can't go around that person again. Because if I go around that person, I'm going to get Holy Ghost fire. If I go around that person, Jesus will be after me. Strong. It's just so easy for a human being to love an ex-human being, and then after, people will make remarks, it is so hard to love God. Why? Because you can't see him? You cannot see him? Let me ask you something. Somebody just call you and tell you they have $10 million for you. Somebody sign over something in your name. $10 million. I show all your pores in your hand raised. All the hair in your head raised. And next thing you start crying, and you haven't seen the money yet. Eh? You haven't seen nothing yet. But you start crying. You want to talk to this one and that one and next one. You know, somebody give me $10 million. And you haven't seen the money yet. Let me ask you something. You can't see Jesus with your physical eyes. But when Jesus said he will never leave you, and he will be with you at all times. Why this excitement can come upon you? Why this excitement cannot come upon you? Why? 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 Come on, why? Why? Hey, let me tell you something. Your faith must build and become strong. Faith is being sure of what is not seen. That'll be sure. That we have seen. And the evidence of things hoped for. That'll be sure. Indira, I told you again, God will raise out your two hands straight. God straighten your back, but you have your part to do. No compromising. No compromising. Amen. I love you very much. No compromising. Come. Come. In my life of ministry, walk straight. Walk straight. Come. Hallelujah. I have confidence and I'm sure. Raise your hands, is it? Next one. This one only reaching up to there, right? But this one has to go up. This one has to go up higher than this one. And I believe in God for that. Because this one and all was here. Is it true? When I first see it, And just a few months, this was right here. And it couldn't go up. And this one going up. So if God could raise this one, why can't I raise this one?
He will.
He will. But you know something, we who just delay the process. It was a little higher.
Injection
from
the doctor,
remember? You want to get injection from God now? What do you think about that? Huh? Close your eyes and raise your two hands. Raise your two hands. And Holy Spirit, lift up our hands, Lord. Lord, stretch out our hands. Lord, stretch out our hands. Lord, let your power stretch our hands out, Lord. Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, stretch it out. Lord, by your Holy Ghost power. Lord, straighten our back. Lord, in Jesus' name. See the Spirit, what God is doing with your hands. Anything you see God doing, you do it. Small miracle at all. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Somebody say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Not much.
You don't have that much. Right where you're sitting there, in your foot, you're going to feel a fire coming. A fire coming right on your foot, right where he is. Right where he is. It's happening right now. Fire, you start to feel a heat coming up in your foot. You feel that? You know that happening? It's starting to get more and more hot. Because God wants to heal your foot today. God wants to heal your foot today, Sister Company. I remember I was in the radio station live and I went there, man. She felt her pain. But she said she feeling a fire in her back. I said a fire from your back when you run down on your foot. But I couldn't see the woman, there's no television or anything. I couldn't see the woman through the radio. All of a sudden I started hearing the next side. Ooh, you. And she started to jump up. And she wanted fire. But I was just using my feet. But Sister Carmine, this morning, the fire of God going to put out all that pain from the foot. All that pain from the foot going to leave. Alright, everybody, the God we serve is concerned about everyone. You have to make your choice. And the choice you make is the price you will pay. Amen? The choice you make is the price you will pay. I just want to call my brother here. Come on. Oh.
First time you come here, what are you experiencing in the ship? What?
I experienced some deliverance, you know, with myself and my family. You know, we were out of the presence of God, you know, for some time. And, you know, being from ministry to ministry, you know, you always search for that place. And, you know, actually coming here this morning, you know, you felt the presence of God. You felt deliverance. You felt this anointing. You felt this power. And, you know, Christ said, you know, by the stripes of Jesus, we are healed. And, you know, waking up this morning is such to give God praise and thanks. You know, for life. You know, because I could have lost my wife last month in an accident. And, you know, in a backslidden condition many years ago, you know, I started to go to church, you know, in 3 weeks time, 3 weeks straight. And all of a sudden, this accident just came with my wife. She just left home seconds and this accident took place. You know, and, you know, God actually healed her. His healing process is very fast, you know, and, you know, she had gotten two fractures on her spine and two on her ribs. And, you know, some people might be able to walk for the rest of their life, you know, and I just want to thank God for allowing her to walk, right? And His power, His healing power is very strong. So, you know, actually being in a ministry like this, you know, it gives us, it teaches us, you know, to pray and seek and fast and pray, you know, and, you know, all these things could be added unto us once we give God our full focus on Him, which He rightly deserves. Right, I just want to thank God, you know, for my family, you know, and everyone that is here, and thank God for Prophet, you know, for actually intercessing and helping us through, and God using him as an instrument, and his wife, you know, as instruments to be there for people who could be affected. And I just want to say thanks very much.
And you know something, the father was telling me that when he heard that they were here, he always wanted to come and meet us. He always wanted to come here, see, you know, what it was about. He wanted to come. But I know I'm standing next to him. There's an empty spot in his heart, and that place needs to be filled. As even hear him talk, as he speak gracefully and so humble and nice, there's an empty place in his heart that God want to fill. And just close your eyes right there, just close your eyes. And I feel him pouring out his spirit in that empty place. He's filling that place now. He's filling that place. He's filling up that place with love. You're going to fall back in love all over with Jesus again. And you're going to be there for your family. You're going to encourage them. You're going to be there for your wife. Wow. He's filling it right now. He's filling it right now. Because in your spirit, that place where that pain was, God want to exchange it this morning. He's pouring it out. Wow. It's coming. It's coming. It's coming. He's filling you. It's filling. Wow, that's a strong anointing. That is a mighty anointing that is upon him right now. A mighty, mighty anointing. He's filling him right now. Filling that place that was void. Lord, that place that remained void, fill him. Fill him, Daddy. Receive him, receive him, receive him. Let's receive him. Receive him. Receive him, receive him. Let's receive him. Receive him. Receive him. Receive him. For so long. He's a nice boy. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. You really have a blessed family here. A really wonderful family. The Bible says a good tree bringeth good fruit. Amen. And a mango don't fall far from a tree. So when you look at the desire the father has, God placed back that desire in the son. So I want to thank God for that. Just like Brother Raja and Aaron. Amen. I want to thank God so much. Daniela, come. Come, baby. Come. Prophet, it's about a long dress like that, you know? Or a different color.
I experienced the blood of Jesus Christ throughout this entire, and right now seeing everyone being healed from and being delivered was truly a blessing.
So how are you feeling being chosen?
I feel great.
Repeat after me. Say, Lord Jesus, Lord, I ask you, Lord, to come into my life. Lord, bring change. Lord, I ask you, Lord, Lord, to remove. I hear nobody. Lord, I ask you to remove, Lord, all the obstacles, Lord, from my way. Lord Jesus, come and fill that place. Lord, I ask this in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know what? I just want to do one last before we dismiss. Come here. Come fast. Come fast. Surely goodness, I want to make a statement in this church. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Come on, let's make a statement this morning, man. Brother George, good morning. I said, now wake up there. All right.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Goodness and mercy shall I'm
Glad you could get him off. Yes.